You got one of these, I'm sure you do. Everyone's got one in their closet. An old Commodore 64. They sold millions of these things back in when was it, Joshua?
82.
1982.
Yeah.
Joshua Brentano, our esteemed producer and longtime screensaver, is here. You were a Commodore fan when you were a little guy.
7 years old.
Is this yours?
No.
No.
This is ours, broke. We played it too much.
Yeah. This was a very, very popular computer, and there were a lot of games on it. And, you know, if you look at the games in the old computers, they're not as sophisticated as the games that we're used to.
Right.
But because you played them when you were young, there's this nostalgia. Yeah. You want to play them again.
That's right.
So and tell me what you did here.
Well, what I've done is I ended up with, I don't know, hundreds and hundreds of games that we got way
on
back.
On discs or on
floppy
cartridges?
On 5 1/4 floppy disk. Yep. And what you can do is you can take those discs and turn them into ROMs, into images. And we've talked about those before on the show.
Right. That's
to
what
play in your emulator.
That's like what you download for an emulator.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
And so what you can do actually is connect your Commodore to your PC and store all those ROMs on your PC, but still use the hardware, the Commodore equipment to load and play them.
Who needs an emulator when you got a Commodore 64?
When you have the real
thing. Is it better to do this way?
No.
No.
I think it's more fun.
Well, there's certain, I gotta tell you.
It depends.
The
joystick.
An actual joystick, and these are the old Atari style joysticks, really aren't the same. And it is better playing it with these.
It is. Yeah. They're designed for these joysticks, not a big sidewinder or something like that.
You gotta look at these, folks. I'm gonna put the joystick down, cause look at this. This thing weighs more than my laptop. What was this thing?
Floppy drive.
That's all that is. A floppy drive, just a few hundred K. So do you need one of these to start with?
You don't. What you can do is you can.
If you have them on floppy,
you can put them into your PC that way.
Okay. So you would hook this up to your PC and using some special software.
Yes.
You dump the images onto your PC.
Right.
Your PC hard drive can hold all of those images.
Right. Or you can go online and get them from one of my favorite sites is C64.com.
You can download them.
They have every ROM there you could possibly want.
Now this is the key, right?
That's the key. That's an XE1541 cable.
Okay.
And it's a specially designed cable that's wired to go from your Commodore on the back.
Let's show the back here. So this goes into the floppy drive port of the Commodore.
Goes right there, and then it goes to the parallel port of your PC.
Ah, so there's key number one. You got to have a PC with a parallel
port.
That's the old style printer
port.
No USB adapter. Nothing
yet. All right,
okay.
And the biggest key is choosing the computer you're going to use.
Why?
Because the program we're going to use here is called 64HDD, and it works in DOS. And you can get it to work on a machine that has Windows and that sort of thing, but it's much easier just plain old DOS, pre-Windows DOS.
So that program is the one that loads the images.
It loads the
image. Then, so basically it's turning this hard drive-based PC into a floppy disk drive to service the Commodore 64.
And the PC you want to have a Pentium 486, something slower to get the two computers to kind of match speed.
Where do you get the cable?
You get the cable from a number of sites online. I have it in the article.
Is it expensive?
About $15.
And then the software is freely
downloadable? It's free. Okay. You can get a professional
version. Show us how it works.
So right now on the PC here, we're running the program called C64 or 64HDD.
Look at that. It looks just like a Commodore.
Well, that's because it is the Commodore.
Oh, we're looking at the Commodore
right now.
Oh, all right.
So on the computer screen.
That would explain it.
On the computer screen, loading this program is the biggest pain because there are a bunch of different switches and settings and that sort of thing.
You document that on our site?
It is in the article, yes.
Okay, great.
It's on there. And so it's just a matter of finding those settings and matching them up. And so you start the server.
So if we can switch over, Christian, to the PC screen, which will be a black and white DOS
screen. Exactly.
And show that. That's the program.
That's the program running. And so you have the program, you define it as device number 8.
Okay.
Point it to the directory where they're stored and a bunch of other switches here.
The nice thing is a hard drive can hold literally
everything.
Every Commodore game ever made.
It can. It absolutely can. I don't know, probably only a couple hundred megs.
Let's load a game.
Now we'll load a game.
You got it running on this side. That makes the PC look like a floppy disk drive to our Commodore.
I just started the server.
Okay.
And as soon
now
as you
on the Commodore,
on, we're going to load the directory there.
That's what that dollar sign is.
Exactly. I even separated them all alphabetically. So that means directory name B.
So
we're going to load that. And then we have to actually load the contents of the directory.
So the 8 is the drive that you select.
Exactly.
The drive. Okay.
And listed. So
and
there
list.
Are all the ROMs
look at
that
all
I downloaded.
Games. And that's just the ones beginning with B!
Exactly. I'm going to list that
Let's
again.
Play a game.
We'll play a game. We will play BC's Quest for Tires. So what you have to do is load the ROM, which is BC
I remember
Quest.
That. BC Comics.
Yep.
Quest for Tires.
And it's loaded there.
Anybody who had a Commodore will remember these load commands. I mean, this is obscure to me, but I presume this is standard for a Commodore.
Yes. Okay. Let's see if this works here. Oops.
Press play on tape.
Exactly.
Well, this you have to tell it's a drive, not a tape. Loading. List.
So there it is.
It's in basic.
We're going to load the game, which is loading the first thing on the disk.
Memories of
and
the way
now we're gonna
we
run
used
it.
To compute.
Now, if you listen way down here on the computer, you can hear a clicking.
Yeah.
Click, click, click. It's loading one block. And so it's got to load 70-some blocks. How many ever blocks the program is.
Pick. But right. It has to do that. Otherwise, it'll be too fast.
It'll be
the C64.
Too fast. Exactly.
Do you find that? Now, the games are playing on the C64, so they're not going to play too fast.
No.
So the only issue really is you got to have a computer that runs DOS well.
Exactly.
And that means not XP.
Not XP.
Not NT, not 2000.
The program has worked on there, and the creator of the program has got to work on a bunch of different places. But my experience, it's best is
Windows 98 or 95, and then a DOS.
Exactly.
Although, since these images are so small, you could probably fit the images on the DOS disk.
You could.
Multiple images.
Easy.
Here it is.
Here it is.
Oh, I like this. I remember this. There he is.
And we loaded it off on the PC.
But it's running on the Commodore.
That's right, using all
the this
colors.
Is actually has a practical use, because if you had on your floppies word processing documents, other data that you wanted to resurrect that you needed desperately because you spent years putting in all this stuff, you can also do it as well, right? And be able to read those and mount them and use them.
20 years ago.
20? Is it really that long?
Right? Yeah,
20 years ago. And you were just a young lad.
Yes.
All right. Anything else we need to know? This is a great thing to be able
practice,
to do.
Practice. You have to get in and tweak and get it to work.
Load quote dollar sign quote comma eight. Very
eight,
important.
Very important.
Don't forget it, folks. That's for right. instructions on how to use your original C64 with your PC, check out Joshua's article, all the details of the screens. Why? Oh, you got smushed.
Well, I died.
At thescreensavers.com. Keep playing. We got to play this in our LAN party.
We will.
Oh, look at that. Still to come around real fast.